Hello. Hi. You can see the twisting orb of the same fucking station that's in every single system in this fucking galaxy spinning around there, so we must be doing late dangerous. This is the first in a long line of Next Muffin podcasts where we just talk about random shit. I do have notes here, but they're not really, you know. I don't think I'll be sticking to them. I'm still recovering from the football last night. I've not quite got over my arse is still stinging from the absolute pounding it received on social media this morning. So yeah, let's get on with the
brutal.
If only you had a soundboard, you could have just gone, oh, I'll just take that and
yeah, that's got to be one of the worst defeats everything's had, isn't it, in the derby?
Yeah. I mean, the last one that went like that, we beat them 3-0 at our place, but yeah, we haven't had a 4-0 in a while.
Right.
They just turned over and let them win, basically. Because we've got a game on Saturday that's really important, so I didn't agree with.
Yeah, I mean, I can understand them trying to save themselves, but yeah, there's no need to go that dramatic.
No. Anyway, let's have a look at these Starport services. Horizon's going to be on sale soon, so might get it. And it's on sale. Just give them a fuck you.
Right.
I will buy it for
£2.
I thought
you got it free or something. I don't know
about that. No, that never came off in the end. They rescinded it, so I was like, oh.
Right.
Help repair our station. I'll accept and give you some money, that's fine.
87,000 light seconds. That'll take me half an hour.
Tell Anaki they like me now, that's nice. Oh, is it for the whole system that they like you? That's cool. So it's not just station by station. That's more.
Yeah, it's affiliated to the party that you're donating to. So you can actually, like, say your empire, you can only donate, like, if you see an empire faction that wants donations, give it to them, and then there's a good chance that that sort of party will succeed in that system.
Where is the back market? Is it on the bulletin board?
Just have a look. Oh no, it's in contacts.
Contacts. Yay, black markets. I want to sell illegal goods, please. There you go. No, I don't need to get any more fucking. Yeah, you can have the rush as well. Don't want that.
I'll have a look at Twitch.
So yeah. What's going on with the channel? We got some more roleplay stuff coming up. Gonna be a big year for that. Huge year, actually. I'm stepping down from doing a lot of DMing stuff because, frankly, I do enjoy it, but I need a holiday. I need a break. I think you can tell in some of the sessions as well. I really do need a break. Apart from Star Wars, that was the only one I can throw myself into because I don't need to describe many things, because as soon as I say something, you all know what Star Wars is, so it's right in your head. Whereas other things, I need to laboriously describe every single little detail so it's in your head. And it's just like, oh, you know. So, going to take a little break. News at the moment is we've got a Shadowrun San Francisco campaign coming up, which will be done by Tim, who's been on Driftwood. He's going to GM that. I'll be writing the rules for it, and just, you know, the bod rope, and I'll probably be writing the setting as well, because I like Shadowrun, and I can do that in my spare time. And we're also doing a Minerva's Cradle campaign that I won't be doing. I'm not actually doing the next Minerva's Cradle campaign after 2.0, which is nice. I think I'll be playing in both campaigns. Well.
Nice.
On top of that, we've got Driftwood coming up, Driftwood 2, which Seddy's in, and a few other people. Steady and three Americans, basically, are all going to be.
That's the name of the entire campaign: Steady and Three Americans.
Steady and Three Americans.
It's not being called. Not being called Driftwood anymore.
No. We don't do that no more. So yeah, Steady is going to be in that. We've got Star Wars Redemption. It's going to finish up probably early next month. Nova's Cradle 2.0 will finish up early next month. And we also got the World of Saga starting up sometime in the summer. That can be one of the big marquee summer campaigns, is the World of Saga 3. So yeah, and Driftwood will be there, obviously, in that. So the plan for this month is finish Star Wars and Minerva early May, and then we start Shadowrun, San Francisco. We're going to start that. So I'm not doing that, so I don't need to worry about it. We're going to start Driftwood 2 next month, towards the middle or end of next month. And then, hang on, I've actually got the actual thing here. Just give me a second. In fact, you know what I'm going to do? Is this even... not really. Okay. Gonna have me a little look at the what, you know, how do you have in Shadowrun San Francisco? There we go. So yeah, I've got it in front of me. So April, Minerva's Cradle 2.0, Star Wars Redemption, and that should finish. Minerva's Cradle will finish this month, so you know. May, we start Shadowrun San Francisco in mid-May. Star Wars Redemption finishes in early May, and Driftwood 2 starts around about the end of May. June, Shadowrun San Francisco carries on. Driftwood 2 carries on, probably finishes, because we only do 10 parts, it's like a TV series. And World of Saga 3 starts in June, because we've got the summer then. So July is Shadowrun San Francisco, World of Saga 3 carrying on, and the new Minerva's Cradle, which I'm not doing, will be in July. And it just carries on like that until October. So that's what we're doing in terms of good old, you know.
Sounds good. Yeah. How do you feel about letting Dan adopt your baby then?
It's fine. Like, I'm quite relieved, actually. I'm kind of... because it came to a point where I was just like, you know what? This is starting to get fucking... stupid now. I'm just tired. I can't bother doing it anymore. And I think I need to take a step back to just, you know.
Yeah, so you're just like relieving all responsibility, or do you have any say at all?
Yeah, no, I'm relieving all responsibility. Yeah, I'm writing the world for both. So even though I mean, Minerva is such a big galaxy, you know, he can do whatever he wants, and I can just, you know, move the timeline forward. Doesn't really matter, because I'm not writing books in it, am I? So, I'm going to write the world for it. So after they finish Minerva's Cradle 2.0, that'll change the galaxy somewhat. So I'll write the world for it, the galaxy for it, the guide, and then he can take that and do whatever he wants. But so I'm still kind of controlling it, because I'm giving him what he's having, you know what I mean? I'm giving him what he's going to be using. So, you know, it's not that bad.
Okay, so yeah, I need to drop him a message, see if he needs anything delegating, because you mentioned about the space system or whatever.
Yeah.
Just see if he needs any help with that. Cool.
Let's go here. System map. Tranquility, Starlight, Stone. What? No, you idiot. No. Good start, game. Can I search for Tarak Tor, please? Yes, there's Minerva. No, Tarak Tor, please. Yeah, that's Minerva. No. For fuck's sake. Tarak Tor. Right, there we go. System map.
Did you get a good mission?
No. Oh. I'm doing raise again. At least I'm earning money and I'm not being fucking annoyed.
Yeah.
See if anything's changed on the mission board.
I mean, it could be a question of just doing the raise until you rank up your trading skill. And then you'll be able to get a lot more.
Yeah, it doesn't go up very quick though, does it? Because I did a rare one the other day and it went from 15% to 16%, for fuck's sake. Which is just
fucking hell, really.
Stupid, yeah. And it was a full hold of rares. I mean, come on. Frontier, right. Give us a break.
Well, firstly, it shouldn't even be in the game. I really think they could strip that out altogether. It's just limiting players needlessly.
Mm.
But yeah, each mission like that I'm doing seems to up it by like 100%, so it must be per transaction that you get the trading skill, not depending on like the amount of time and effort you put into doing it.
Obtain gallium for processing at Tower Nikki. Thanks to new working practices, processing capabilities are outperforming You're looking to source shipments of gallium through freelance contracts, deliver a batch of three. I don't need to mine this, do I? I can just go and buy it, can't I?
I'm going to check now, just in case it is one of them ones that you can only mine. Hang on, let's see. It says it's a good item to trade. It doesn't say whether it's... no, I think it is. I think it is something you can just buy.
Cool.
So yeah, sounds alright.
Alright, so...
It says produced by unknown. So I don't know what that sounds like.
Alright.
Let's see. Yeah, I think you can get it. Try it on a elite trading show, just like to look for a gallium and see what that says. If nothing comes up, then you know it's one that you have to mine for.
Find trades. Let's just see on the trade calculator what I can get. End system, start system, any, end system, can I just do any?
Yeah, you just remove the end system, like just leave it blank or something, it shouldn't.
100 cash,
The thing is, if you leave it all blank, it's just going to find something that's on the other end of the galaxy that's really lucrative. Like 500 light years away or something. Ridiculous. Yeah. So you might want to put... I don't know.
See what it comes up with.
Great one. Yeah, you're probably best using the Find Trades tab and then put your current location and how far away you're prepared to travel to it. Like 40 light years away, and then it'll find the best thing. Oh, I don't know. Minerva. So apparently you get 3,474 credits per ton.
Mm-hmm.
If you take Imperial Slaves from Kappa Phonesis to Tarak Tor, and then bring performance enhancers back. And it's 29 fight years.
Wow.
There's one that's only 8. Yeah, there's one that's 8 light years in between.
So it's
and that's marine equipment and then imperial slave. Just go on the find trades tab and click Minerva and then maximum search range, and it will find you the best route.
It says
that imperial slaves one sounds quite good.
Yeah, imperial slaves to Charactor, so very good to Kappa for Onassis.
Only if you want to do the 29 one, but I'm saying that if you look two, like the third one down is only 8 light years apart, so you could easily do that in one jump. Whereas the 29 one, you can do two jumps.
I can do 29 in one jump in this thing.
Fully laden?
Probably not, but it's going to be more. Actually, yeah, you are right, yeah. So
yeah, 918 light seconds away from the star, 359. Yeah, they're all reasonable distances. So, it's not like you're having to travel
thousands
of light seconds.
Marine equipment, Gibbetok. Oh,
yeah, that's the one that seems. I'd probably come and do that now. I've done this. I mean, that's pretty good profit, 3,300 per ton. And if you've got a cargo space of 100 on, oh, that's like 300 grand, just one way, I think, isn't it? Really hard to do some of the military career stuff at some point.
Okay. Yeah, we need a better ship for that though. I need a bloody good Cobra to do that.
Yeah, or Vulture. Yeah. I mean, kitted out Vulture was only 7 million or something.
Yeah, but that would leave him with nothing. So.
Oh, I thought you had like quite a bit.
No, I spent a lot of it upgrading this again. So, because I would really want to do like a fucking big, massive. Yeah, how much cargo hull do I have?
Gens Force. I think it's 112 or something like that. Engines engaged.
100 now.
Alright. I mean, you can always trade in your type 6. Landing gear retracted. Depends. Top off sensors.
Oh, I don't want to debug camera mode on. Return me to my ship, please. There we go.
Frameshift drive charging.
So it sounds like you've had enough of res trade and then you want to do that again.
Yeah. I mean, if I'm just going to make more money doing this.
Yeah, it's just all of them can really fuck you off doing that. One, like you said, you can't make just it's like a real job, just going backwards and forwards.
Oh, my cabin's gone fucking mental here. It's all disappeared, and I'm just looking at space. Great.
Whoa. Have you accidentally done debug camera?
Yeah, but now I've got it back off now.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scoop disengaged. Fuel scooping.
It's going to be quite nice to play and maneuver myself. That's going to be quite nice.
Yeah, you deserve it, man.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
It's been years, hasn't it, doing DMing.
Yeah. It's taken a long time, but I think finally...
Frameshift drive charging.
I'm gonna get to do shit.
And you can rip into people if they fuck up.
Nah, I wouldn't do that.
4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
What sort of character am I thinking of playing in Minerva? I don't know.
Myself.
God. I don't know. I honestly don't know. I'm probably going to be a human or a drain, because those are my... I don't really have favourites, because I'm kind of the author, so I'm not allowed to have favourites, but... I'll probably go with a drain or human. Minerva, you know.
Uh-huh.
And, I don't know, I always like guns. So I'd probably just be a gunman again, because I like guns. I like my guns.
Gender?
I think, a male. But I think because my Shadowrun guy is like a sniper. I think I might make the Minerva guy like all-out gunslinger. Like, you know, just got two revolvers and just goes to town on people, sort of thing. And probably give him. I'd probably make him... I don't know. I said I'd probably make him a gunslinger and medium armor and just like a merc, basically. I might actually make him a pilot as well, but I think Mara's got that position like boxed off, so not much point in doing it. I might make him like a fighter pilot rather than a starship pilot, so he's like, if we get like a fighter ship, we can just, you know, do that. Quite cool.
Yeah, sounds like that. It's gonna be pretty lonely though if you're just flying everywhere in this little fighter following the.
No. It would be in the hangar, wouldn't it? And then when we needed it, I'd get it out.
Oh,
okay. So like Mara would drive the actual ship, and I'd just drive the drop ship or something. You know, because I'm better with a smaller ship, and she's better with the larger ship.
Yeah.
I'd really love to, like, because the next Minerva campaign is going to be like true sandbox, which is the first one we've ever done. Because that's how it should be for somebody's first campaign. Yeah, they shouldn't really do a story. They should just do a true sandbox.
Docking request granted.
I mean, it's a lot more pressure on the DM, though, isn't it?
No, it's a lot more doing a full-on story because you've got to write one.
Well,
you know.
Yeah, you can understand partly that, but I mean, the spontaneous nature of what it could be could frighten. Like, if you're not very spontaneous in your imagination, you could end up getting yourself into a bit of a pickle as a DM,
if you don't, if you don't have a spontaneous imagination, you shouldn't be DMing in the first place. Do you know what I mean? It's like it's basically 90% of what a DM does.
I get that, but I'm saying if you write a sort of storyline, it's a lot more controlled experience, isn't it?
It is, but
you preempt a bit.
But as a new DM, you'd be far too, you'd railroad far too much. Do you know what I mean? Like, the only reason I didn't do that in Ventio is because they just stuck to it. Like, they didn't go away from the story at all. I was really surprised. I thought they'd just do their own thing, but they didn't. Whereas, you know, I think if they didn't do that, I probably would have tried to railroad them. So you should always start, in my opinion, you should always start with a nice sandboxy campaign that you can just jump in and out of. You know, you're not really getting annoyed when people don't turn up, because it's a sandbox, and you know, it doesn't matter if people aren't there, because it's a sandbox. They're just off doing their own thing, whilst, you know, other people are doing shit.
Yeah, I get, there's pros and cons to it, both of them, in my opinion.
Yeah, I prefer the narrative one, but
yeah.
We're going to cap on that. Kappa.
Oh, so you're doing the top one, right?
No, you gotta go to Kappa on the second one as well.
Oh, you do, apparently.
Yeah.
Oh, fucking hell, I landed on a pad the wrong way around, so 2 minutes of me trying to rotate the fucking thing.
That can't be the same Kappa, I'm sorry, that is 100 odd fucking light years away. Kappa 4 Nassus. Yeah, okay, I knew that. Good.
Yeah, because research range was only 40 light years. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not finding jack shit in terms of mission, so I'll probably get all that. Let me see.
The Orca really does look like a vibrator, doesn't it? I mean, it's like a bullet vibrator.
You're my Glimpson. It's a reminder of tribal. Everything's a sex point.
It's a dark, dark, dark place. Do you ever watch Funny Bones when you were a kid? It's that song all the time. When it's a dark, in a dark, dark room, in a dark, dark cellar. There is tribal's mind. Look, he's fucking a good.
I have to watch a clip of that.
Drive charging. Yeah, I think GM should go into. I'd probably say the ideal for me is going into a session with. If it was just a normal campaign I was doing, I'd probably plan 70% of it and then have the other 30% just being completely. You know, player generated randomness that could end up being the entire session if that's what they want to do. Whereas I think a new guy should definitely stick to a, because if you do a sandbox campaign, the players are sort of GMing as well, if you know what I mean. It's like a collaborative effort. Yeah. Like everyone's sort of getting on board. And everyone's saying, "Okay."
Just random sort of bullshit.
Like they're making things happen, and the GM is the GM isn't a GM if they're not a storyteller and they haven't got an imagination. So, you know, they'd be like, "Okay, yeah, that happens," and then this happens and this happens, and it's much easier for a new GM to do that. It takes the pressure off.
Yeah.
Because, you know, if the players aren't doing anything, then they're just crap players, and you can go, well, you know. It's a sandbox campaign, you do what you want, just do whatever you want. So that's what Minerva's going to be, is like a big old sandboxy.
I would have thought still with a sandbox you still have to have some sort of progression or planning, because
yeah.
Like what if say for example, they're in the cantina or whatever, and the bar fight happens and all this random stuff starts happening, there's going to be a point where the players are like, well, what are we doing here now? And you sort of have to kind of throw them a bone, I would have thought.
Yeah.
At certain points.
I mean, almost all the time I basically say, look, you know, if you're going to do a campaign, then it should be, you know, even in a sandbox campaign, you're not really writing the story, you're writing the world. So, like, in Minerva, you'd be like, okay, what system are we in? Okay, well, I'm gonna invent some governments and some conflicts that are going on and some jobs that are available in the cantina and some, you know, that sort of thing. That's what you write as a GM in a sandbox campaign. So, when the players say, hey, what's here? You can go, oh, it's da-da-da-da-da-da, and he wants you to do a job in da-da-da-da-da-da, you know, that sort of thing. And you fill out all the characters that are in the bar and things. Like, okay, so who's in the bar? Okay, it's Derek, the spice trader. He wants you to take 20 tons of spice, but he needs you to watch out for pirates because there's pirates on his ass who want his shipments because they want them to close down. And so you've got to take this to Praxis 4 and, you know, that sort of thing. And you see, off the top of my head, you know, it's just... So,
yeah,
it's a lot easier than a written campaign, because Star Wars, for instance, is fucking, you know, that would be intimidating for a normal player, because they'd be like, I've got to write basically a Star Wars movie and make it so that it's playable. So, and you've got to keep everyone happy, because the Force users have to feel awesome, but at the same time, you can't leave everyone behind, because that's just not fun for anyone. You can't just say, well, you know, the Force users are great and everyone else is shit. You gotta, like, you know.
Yeah. That was ridiculous, that fight, though. Like, when, what do you call it? By the, fuck's sake. You know the boss at the end of the last session? I can't remember. Your companion guy.
Oh, yeah.
It was quite funny, the fact that I seem to be getting all these critics and hits on him, and the fucking boss users are just
yeah,
getting all the damage and they're just not really doing anything. But that's just the way the dice
Roll. Who really nearly got flattened straight out? It was Drox, wasn't it?
Was it Drox? Yeah, I think it was Drox, actually.
Yeah, nearly got the state obliterated, died.
Yeah.
Landing gear retracted.
Oh shit.
Well, that's the lust for ball shooters. Landing gear deployed.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I know how they're gonna die, if they do die. They'll get the lightsaber and they'll be like, yes! And they'll like, go running in to like a Sith Lord or something thinking, yeah! And then they'll just get fucking annihilated because, you know, you just cut straight through them and chops them to pieces. I think that's what's gonna happen. Okay.
20 years of Force training compared to 2 weeks of Force training.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Let's see what happens.
Yeah. Have you seen those, what's the word? Alien artifacts in this game now? They're in those shells that break your ship if they're in your hold. Because they just keep singing. It's fucking funny, that.
You're on about release?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I heard something about that. Something about another type of, I don't think it's an alien artifact, but it's some sort of relic that you can get that, it gradually causes damage on your ship.
Mm.
So, it's like a race against time to try and get it to a star farm spot before, your ship. It's like highly radioactive or something.
Okay, that was like 12 grand's worth of profit. I don't think I'll be doing this anymore.
Really?
Yeah.
And that was taking Imperial slaves to our marine equipment.
That was taking
marine... Profit is only 141 going, but it's 3,170 coming back. If you look at the, but it still works out more profitable.
Oh, yeah, Kappa Imperial Slaves to Jibitok.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah. just like a token sort of cargo load, and then you get the money going back. Got enough for fucking 8,000 credits.
Wow, they were expensive.
Illegal cargo. Huh? Why do I have illicit cargo when I've not got any jobs? Hold on a second. I must have something in my cargo bay that I didn't realize I had. Oh, I have stolen marine equipment apparently that I don't remember. Fine. Okay.
I'll do it. Come on then, Imperial slaves, on you come. Nope. No, I'm not selling them, I'm buying them. Go. So. So you've got a hold full of slaves.
100 tons of slaves.
Yep.
How many fucking people is that? That's just ridiculous.
Mm.
1,000 people in the back of your ship.
Alright. See you tomorrow. Huh? I have no idea what she just said.
Like a DJ at the wedding.
Yeah.
The buffet is open. Oh, I heard that bit.
You should come up on a Sunday, man. Should be fun. Like, we're gonna go. It's not really a big thing. We're just gonna go out and have a few jars. Since I've been golden, I've been losing weight.
Get up on Sunday.
Yeah, okay, I've got like.
Yeah, you inspired me too. I've been doing it for the past week or so.
Oh, good man. Good man.
Cheers.
I've cut like all sugar out of my diet, basically, and all fat. Well, most
same
fat. Yeah. And
I've been cutting out all of the dairy stuff as well.
Yeah.
That's a difficult thing.
I have milk, but that's pretty much it. Because I have tea. I can't live without tea. I'll go fucking spare without tea. Then.
Yeah, I'm just having black coffee all the time. It's quite revolting really, but seems to be sufficing.
So I've got that. You cut out all crisps and shit and fried foods, and even if I have meat, I cook it properly and get rid of all the fat and stuff like that. And things. Eat loads of veg. I have like 5 a day now, like every day. And I've lost like 0.8 stone. So, and that was last week. So hopefully I've lost a bit more now.
Good man. Are you doing any exercise with it, or are you just?
Just walking. Like, if got a choice of driving or walking, just drive. Just walk.
Yeah.
Or getting a bus or walking. Because the thing is that I've got to work on uni stuff, like near all day, every day. And then when I'm not working on uni stuff, all my hobbies revolve around me sitting at the PC, either typing or playing games. So.
Yeah. So.
I don't really want to change that lifestyle, because, you know what, fuck it, you know, that's my life, screw it, I'm not, you know, I'm fine with it.
Friendship.
Whereas,
charging.
So, I'm losing weight slower than I would be if I was doing running and stuff. I'd be, you know, I'd have dropped well over a stone by now if I was, you know.
Doing Ironmans and that every day.
Yeah. Three, two, one, engage. But it is nice as well, when I'm running down the stairs, me boobs no longer fucking jiggle up and down, which is nice. Like, they're proper pecs now, which is nice. I've give the missus something to cheer about when she gets over here.
You just running up and down stairs, look.
Look at my boobs, there's no boobs there. It's great.
They no jiggle no more.
No.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
No jiggle for me. Yeah, I feel it all right all the way around, like, you know, just running and stuff. I don't feel like I'm swaying or jiggling as much. It's not, you know, it's good. My belt rungs are going up. I need to buy a new pair of jeans, because these ones are fucking, look like a cancer patient. No offense to people who are cancer patients, but don't particularly want to look like you. So many people get cancer nowadays. Like Victoria Wood, I didn't even know
she had
cancer.
You hear about Prince dying? Wow. Prince died. Victoria Wood died yesterday, and then Prince died today. Like, what happened? Who's next?
I think,
Who's number?
Of course I'm being interdicted. Why would I not be interdicted? I've got stuff in my hold.
Fundamental law of elite is that people have force powers and they can detect what you've got in your cargo at all times.
Oh, it's an inspection. Right, okay, right.
Scan detected.
I heard this letter to be illegal though.
They're not. They don't say they're illegal.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it is. Are you at, Gibbetog or whatever?
Gibbetog, yeah.
Well, it says illicit cargo. Oh no, I've got that fucking stolen marine stuff. I need to get rid of that.
I submitted to the interdiction, and now it's telling me I've got to fucking cool down on it.
Get out of my cargo hole. Thank you.
Ejected the slave back and. Oh dear. Well, I'll leave them there.
Ready to engage.
272 tons of slaves. Engage. Off you go.
Into the sun.
Nah, man, I've fucking 5 million credits worth of slaves. I'm not letting them go anywhere.
Same.
I plot my corpse, I think it is. Kappa Phonasis.
Did you see China died today? The female wrestler?
No, I didn't know.
Yeah.
Well.
She's only like 45.
Whose number's up tomorrow? No one knows.
Prince died as well, didn't he? So.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. One day after another.
Well, it's David Bowie, isn't it? Prince. Fucking.
Alan Rickman.
Alan Rickman, yeah, that's mental, that, isn't it? Because he wasn't that old, was he?
No.
As soon as Christopher Lee dies, you know, everyone's fucking. You know, he was never gonna die, was he? He's be singing death metal until he's like 90. Well, he was 90, but he'll be singing death metal until he's like 150.
He's one of those people that people used to think that was dead, but
yeah.
He's still going about.
Yeah.
No, he's still alive. But for some reason, rumors start spreading that he's dead and carries on for another 5 years.
When people were going on about him dying, I was like, yeah, there's another one of these. People think he's dead. He was actually dead. I was like, oh.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, that's not very nice.
Did you hear about Gaza or Gascoigne getting a thing about being dying? being dead.
Really?
Apparently the first thing he realised is somebody sent him a text saying, Gaza, are you dead? You don't send the guy a text.
Are you dead, mate? Yeah. Sorry. Died.
Yeah, that's how he replied. He said, yeah.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
I mean, even if he had died and it's his close relatives or whatever, looking at the phone or whatever, you know, they're going to be.
Yeah.
What a fucking brutal way to ask about it, you know.
No one gives a shit. Are you dead? No. Being repaired, fine. Let's see how much I get for this now.
Mm-hmm.
Galactic average by cell. Oh, that's nice. Oh, profit of 316,000. Very nice. Oh, very nice. Very nice.
Oh.
Might outfit my ship to be lighter so I can get more shit in.
Oh, yeah. Probably, yeah. Shields and that if you're there.
Yeah. It's a pity I can't store my equipment somewhere, but I'd have to fucking sell it. Stupid that. I paid for it, let me just keep it. Even charge me rent on it, oh, I don't mind.
Yeah, but the thing is the equipment, you get 100% the value back. It's just a question of having to find the place that buys it, that sells it in order to get it back, right?
Mm. Fuel tank is good.
And I'm gonna crash into the station.
Buy and equip cargo.
Oh, spend detector. So you're at harvest port right now?
Yeah.
I think it's put us in different instances again, because I can't see you on the map.
May as well keep the fuel scoop.
Yeah.
Shield generator.
Oh, they sell onion head, a rare at
yeah, there's only one though.
Harvest pot. I know that, but you might as well keep collecting them. I don't know. Like every time you come back to the station, there'll be another one.
I will buy one onion head, please.
It's 1 ton. That's fucking a lot of onions.
Yeah, I'll have 1 ton of onion heads, please.
What the fuck is happening here? I should have more than... slaves. Come on. Oh, I can buy slaves. Oh no, have I bought them at the wrong place? Then that would be a yes. Fuck my life. I'm not even gonna do it. Let me see how much this is. Fucking 1 million credit loss. I'm going back. I'm selling them back at you.
Not happy.
At least Loparada and Morina, you couldn't actually physically buy it off the wrong one.
Yeah.
No wonder I can't see you on the map then, because I'm not at the wrong fucking station.
Yeah, that'll be it.
Off I go back. Here's the slaves that you've just sold me. Back.
Can't have that back. Fuck off.
Are there many people still in Durham for this Sunday?
No, yeah, they'll be back this Sunday, yeah.
Oh, they're right. They're back now.
There's a frameshift drive here that's like 500,000 odd, but it means at Leyden I've only got 4.98 light years. Fuck.
Yeah, it must be the wrong class for your ship. Like, is it class 2 or something? Your class will be like 3 or something. So it's underpowered.
Yeah, none of them are good enough for this ship.
You really have to go to high tech space stations in order to outfit your ship.
No more shields for me. There goes my sense of security. So, Chibitok to Kappa Phornakis. I am taking marine equipment. Marine equipment!
That's how you get the best deals. Your barter using that voice.
Can I have some marine equipment, please?
That should be your challenge. That's your character's voice now. From an era.
I love dolphin.
The ultimate badass gunslinger, yeah. And fighter pilot, and he got a voice like that.
That criminal scum.
It's getting dangerously close to what Dan Coffey sounds like.
That's me.
Yeah, no, no.
Sound like a fucking mong. There you go. Grimes said that. That's immortalized on the internet forever now as well. Like, oh, did you see what he said to you on a podcast? Oh, no, no, no.
Ship released. Engines engaged.
Only carrying up.
Yeah.
You never did do that copy time.
No, I wanted to.
Radio, did he?
No.
That would have been brilliant.
It was up to him to get it on, up and running. Yeah. I think I'd have been. I only would have done like one segment. It would have just been me by the fire, ranting. Is it? Just ranting.
Landing gear retracted.
No wonder.
Frameshift drive charging.
One jump to Kappa, and one jump back. Should have just gotten rid of the fucking things in the first place, really.
Four, three.
Yeah, I've been watching a good bit of that. Might pick that up. Sometime. Seems quite good.
Yeah, I might get rid of
the price of the game. How long are you back in doing for?
Till Wednesday, but then I'm back again at the weekend, so it's like 2 weeks.
Oh, right, yeah. You're not gonna know what to do with yourself without your desktop.
Well, I've got a laptop there, and I'm only gonna be there for 2 days, and I'll be drinking like Sunday and Monday, and then I'll do work on Tuesday.
Drink away the pain.
Yeah. My precious.
There's my computer.
Yeah.
Here I am with stupid fucking solitaire.
A man cannot play Rocket League, what is he to do? I don't really play any games anymore, to be honest with you. There's none that interest. I've got to wait until my new PC's built. Because I'm going to get Fallout 4 again. And just download all the fucking mods. All of the mods. Just I'm gonna have the weapon.
What do you mean again? Like you've refunded it or something?
No, install, not buy.
Oh right, I thought you actually got rid of it or something. Yeah, then that'd be alright. So do you think you'll replay through the game with
yeah,
the new DLC?
I'll take away his voice, and I'll install mods and stuff. I still don't like the fact that you can't be an arsehole. That's fucking so fucking vanilla and stupid.
Yeah.
It's just like...
You know the very beginning where you get the option to tell the Vault-Tec guy to piss off?
Yeah.
Has anyone done that? Does that fail again?
Yeah, he just, like, fucks up. That's it, you can't get in the vault.
Yeah, just...
There you go.
You're annihilated. At the end of the game.
I don't think it gives you a choice. I think it, like, says, oh, just do this, and he goes, fine. And takes the pen and fills it in. But he does it, like, as an asshole.
Oh, right. Pretty stupid. I mean, they could at least have that just to dick you over. Like, you did the wrong thing, that's your 5 minutes of gameplay done.
Remake your character.
It'd be hilarious if people actually thought that was the game.
Yeah, like, refund it.
GG, no ring!
Yeah.
So the release, the dev kit, so
yeah, I think it's either out or it's just about to come out, but the first one they've already said is going to be the weapons on the back mod, because they've already made it in the Nexus, but you've got to do a bit of tweaking to the INI file to get it to work, which I don't want to do because it never fucking works, so...
So I'm buying marine equipment, am I? Is that the
thing? Where are you?
Yeah, I'm doing the same route as you.
Yeah, but where are you?
What, the Wellman Gateway?
Wellman Gateway,
I'm not
yeah.
buying slaves again.
Yeah, no, you're buying marine equipment.
Okay.
You can take them to Harvest Port and...
Marine equipment,
Docking request granted.
A wide range of industrial scale equipment for marine agriculture.
So how do we get to go to Earth again? What did you say it was?
You have to do a military career in... the Federation. I think it is.
Okay.
I don't know what rank it is before you get the pass or whatever you can get.
Well, I'll carry on doing this till I get like 10, 11 million, then I'll buy and outfit this fucking amazing ship and then I'll do the military career.
Yeah. Sounds good.
Like, I literally do not want to die once, I just want to be like, yep, yeah, everyone's dead, just go and die.
Docking successful. Engines disengaged.
Docking successful. Engines disengaged.
I'm looking for this. Looking forward to this new patch that's bringing out, like, in there.
Yeah.
Which is good as it seems.
What am I getting rid of here? Oh, yeah. Marine equipment. There you go, there's all your fucking snorkels. That's what it is, I've got like 110 tons of snorkels and flippers. I'm giving over. Here we go, we can have them. Now give me some sleeves. It's a lot darker a trip going back than it is going, I'll tell you that.
I know. I want to know where they're getting these people from.
I don't know, it must be fucking SeaWorld here or something. They need all this. So many tons of... So many times.
Maybe that's what they're growing. They're growing people.
The growing people.
It's a conspiracy. Okay. It's a cloning station. It's got to be. Why the fuck would a marine agricultural space station have so many people that they're willing to give up?
Don't talk to me about clones. I still can't go back to the Old Republic yet because I started my play with our other character and of course, who should fucking turn up? Phone number 819 turns up and just...
Arrowhead 2.0.
Yeah.
My god man, that was just ridiculous that everybody's identical.
If you want to run them off,
I keep thinking you must have gone for the default character or something.
No, I didn't. Basically, folks, what happened was that we were playing the Old Republic, and I created my character, and it looked just like the stock character from, like... I didn't do it on purpose, because the stock character stuff came out after I created that character. I promise you it did. And so all of a sudden, my character, the only difference is he had, like, a scar down one side of his face. appears on all of the promotional art. And of course, the NPCs, the Sith NPCs and all sorts,
are
all me, basically.
Landing gear retracted.
Which is the most immersion-breaking thing I think I've ever... Well, apart from steady dancing and all of my fucking scenes. Apart from that, it's the most ridiculously immersion-breaking thing I've ever come across. My career.
Space Elvis has got to do his dancing. That's part of his character.
Scan detected.
Smurf Elvis to the rescue. I think I need to get my Sith Warrior up to level 65 and do the Empire stuff with her because I don't know, it just doesn't seem to really have much meaning being a bounty hunter doing stuff like that.
Charging.
Why the fuck is he getting himself involved in this, really?
Yes. No. I must save the galaxy. Well, no, why the fuck no one wants
him? He's already took over Mandalore, his head of Mandalorians, so I mean, he can just, like, live a happy life and do any normal bounty killing. Why is he fucking getting involved with this dickhead? Vakarian or whatever he's called.
Valkorion. I want to know. Right. This is the thing that got me just not playing it. It was like, oh yeah, this is the Emperor. He's a Sith Emperor. And I was like, okay, well, explain this to me. How is this Empire just cropped up in a couple of hundred years? I mean, look at the size of it. And look at the amount of people who are here. Are you telling me that the Sith Empire was so fucking stupid that they didn't realise that the Emperor just got up and left for 300 years to go and make another state on the other side of the galaxy? It's just fucking stupid, even for Star Wars.
Like, it would never. You know what I think it is? I think BioWare have gone and seen Episode 7, or the script of it, and thought, if it's good enough for them, then it's good enough for us.
Yeah.
You know, let's make this undefeatable force. Oh, unknown force that's massive and menacing spring up out of nowhere.
Yeah.
It works. Yeah. I mean, you don't know, it might get put into context later on. I mean, how far through that stuff are you?
Not very far. I'm on, like, number 9, but I'm just thinking... It can't, can it? Because the way I'm thinking about it, it's just like, you know.
I mean, there's 14 chapters, and it's spent any time really to iron stuff like that out. And it sounds like, with it being so episodic, that they're adding to the story, so even when you get to the last stuff, you're going to have to wait to learn, add another chapter or whatever, which is a bit stupid. I mean, I think I'll probably play as much as I can, keep with the 1 month subscription that I've got, and leave it until they finish up all of the content and then do another month.
Yeah, I probably will do that as well.
Launch the chaff. What the fuck is happening? Thank you.
Apparently Mara is the only pilot in Minerva. I'm sorry. Okay. I didn't realize that. I am barred from being a pilot.
Sounds right.
It's like, Mara can pilot all things. And I was like, okay.
Does that encompass car driving and sort of land vehicle stuff?
I don't know.
You might have a niche there.
Somebody goes to drive and like, no, this is my niche.
This is my moment.
Yeah.
You know for a bad fact that if that happened, you just going to critical fail everything and just like, fuck! This is what I'm supposed to do!
Yeah.
What the hell is happening?
This is my niche! You're fucking up my niche! $347 million 8 million Okay, we're gonna get some more flippers, I think.
Check all you want, I've got nothing on anymore. Have you ever had it where they're trying to scan you and they crash into you and then you get a fine for reckless driving or something?
No.
That happened to you. Just my question, they'll park the ship right in front of where you're going to scan you. And then they give you a fucking 400 credit fine for reckless. I'm not the fucking guy that's parked in front of this massive 200 ton ship. That's, you know what I mean?
So yeah.
You're in a puny fighter, move out the fucking way.
Mm. Still can't wait to get my probably... bigger ship.
Yeah. So much climbing. And that's going to be another thing, isn't it? When December comes round, where they've got these multi-crew ships. I bet they make you do a ton of grinding before you can even get a ship that is multi-crew. Like,
oh, yeah.
I mean, I know my Python I've got here is there's separate seats and that I can take them in.
Oh, yeah, it'll be about 90 million just to buy one of these multi crew ships, so definitely.
I think it could be more than that. I mean, there's ships that base cost 150 million that are in it now. 500 million off you go. So basically I need to do this in my sleep 24/7 for 6 months before I can get that chip. Thank you.
I'm sorry, the cat's on my door and that's
frameshift drive charging.
Stroke me, now I bite you. Fuck off.
I'm loving it. No! I hate you.
Yeah. You do it
too
wrong.
Too much.
You're doing it wrong. Stupid human. Yeah, that's what I was saying, Sam, is that you probably drive the big ship. And he'd just drive, because you can stay with your baby then, which would be the ship that you're piloting, and I can fly the fighter or whatever. I think that's going to be his bio anyway, that he's a fighter pilot, but, like, you know, he's really good with guns.
I don't need that, no more. Strip out my fuel generator.
Slow down. Now speed up. Now slow down. Now speed up.
Are you kidding? What? Oh no. Really? Oh, this place has literally nothing in outfitting. I can't buy bigger cargo then. Oh. I'll have to do it when I get back. Hopefully the other players have.
Seems quite stable, this region of space anyway, so it's quite a good place to do the trade.
Uh-huh.
Well, this cat's moaned for ages to get in. Now he's just like, when are you gonna open the door and let me out? Just like, oh, you wanted to come in here.
He wanted to see if you were sneaking food away from
yeah,
him.
Yeah. This is an inspection.
You have passed the feline inspection. Carry on with your business. Let me out of this room.
It is quite a watery world, so I'm thinking it is like Sea World or something. There with the fucking dolphins and sea lions.
They're packing that in now, aren't they? Stop breeding the killer whales and that.
Yeah, well, the killer whales, I can understand, because they go fucking mental in there. They're supposed to be in a massive boat. Massive seas. They're supposed to be in the sea. That's why great white sharks can't live in captivity. Because they won't eat.
Alright. Man, that'd be crazy, wouldn't it, if they did them tricks with a white great white.
You'd be fucking dead in seconds. You'd be like, right, yeah, see you later. Landing gear deployed.
He's a sardine. There's your arm gone.
There's the upper half of your body just gone. Yeah.
And then you've got Fred, the supervisor. He's learning gradually. He's learning gradually.
Yeah. And I'm now Toby. Docking successful. He's such a grouch in the mornings. He's just there like half a head.
Yeah.
But he's an indigenous.
Get the next
species.
Volunteer.
Yeah, yeah. Bring in the next volunteer. And,
we are trying to teach him to clap with his fins. So far. He just leapt up the water and hit people. Yeah. But there is progress.
But we are confident there will be a good attraction here in the near future. There's going to be, speaking of attractions, there's going to be a Mass Effect ride in San Francisco, in a theme park there.
So alright.
Taking the missus to that.
And what is it, like Normandy or something?
Yeah, it's the Normandy, yeah, you basically just go on the Normandy and... there was a thing on their website where they got like Mark Vandeloo, who is the face model and body model for male Commander Shepard, to dress him up in the gear and just have him just walk around the ship and stuff, not talking. There's like a crew on it and everything. And
so the actual person's going to do that full time?
I don't know if it's full time.
Right, because I can understand getting them in to do like a wax model of him or whatever, like. Having him there all the time.
I don't think he's going to be all the
time.
The
fact he can't talk as well.
Landing yeah, he didn't sound like him.
Bitch voice.
Yeah, he didn't sound like him. Yeah. I just have Mark Meer walking around. It'd be, you know.
Hmm.
Oh, it's in Santa Clara apparently. Wrong again.
Santa Clara.
So we're going to be like my nan granddad, you know, tell, definitely, because she just corrects me all the time. That's what my nan does to me granddad. He goes, oh yeah, fucking wrong again. There you go.
That's me putting me first.
Yeah, yeah.
Scan detected.
request.
Friendship drive charging.
Friendship drive? Where did that fucking cap go?
I am the knight. You shall not see me.
Three, two,
I am in the top corner.
I think he's gone out the window.
Oh. And he can do that sort of stuff, can't he? It's not like literally he's commit suicide or something. He will not let me out.
Thank you,
by
not.
Any means.
Freedom.
Did you hear about that Australian dog, the world's oldest dog, dying a few days ago?
No.
Ridiculous. World's oldest dog. Guess how old?
Oh, not bad. I don't know, 22?
Nah, he was 30-year-old. Ridiculous. You want to see it, man? It looked like it come out of a fucking war zone. Barely walked two steps.
Get me out.
Oh, and I have to carry him about everywhere in there. Man.
Jesus Christ.
Good going, like.
Kind of a life. I think it's like
the equivalent of like 200 in dog years or something ridiculous, if I what the fuck. Yeah. The owner was panicking that he was going to outlive him. He would, yeah, wouldn't he?
Fucking stupid dog. Supposed to be dead. This cat does have 9 lives, like, so yeah, it's been through so much.
All them slaves, off you go. Fucking hell. Yeah, I'll be doing this for a while. 900 grand just from one.
Yeah. Thing.
But I'm in the Python now, so it's a lot more cargo space than I was getting in the Type 7. Yeah.
Yeah, I get about nearly 400 grand.
Each
time.
Yeah, that is good.
Actually, I get 400 grand each time.
What's your next upgrade? Have you not thought about that?
Not thought about it. I'm probably gonna go for a.
I think an Asp Explorer is probably the next one, if I recall rightly, the way I went. Yeah, I think so.
I fucking lost the plot here when we're going.
To Earth.
Oh, right, it's right by the door. Look at that.
Deployed.
Why put them by the door? Well, why put them by the door? You know, of course I'm going to be fucking loitering because you put it right by the door and I can't fucking see where I'm going. Great. Oh, fuck off, I'm not loitering. Go away. Do you know what I mean? Is this fucking stupid? Why are they by the door? If you overshoot then you're going to come back. Such a ball ache to find.
I mean, it wouldn't be so bad if the numbering system made sense.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you can have a number 3 that's at the very back of the thing. And then a number 44, which would be right in front of the door or whatever. So if you understood, like, the first 6 were right by the door or whatever, do it that way around, then you could prepare, but you can't. Because the numbering system's all wrong.
Just like, is it getting fucking messed about by it?
You're kidding me. Oh, well, this is a new type of advert that keeps unmuting itself.
Docking successful.
Not like
engines
that.
Disengaged.
Alright, no. Type 6.
What am I given here? Oh, yeah, Imperial slaves.
You're harvesting Imperial slaves.
And you give marine equipment with the harvesters. That's the way I'm remembering it anyway. I've got my 3 onion heads. Why can't I not find marine equipment?
When am I going back to? Oh yeah, Kappa. For
Nexus.
SeaWorld.
Got three of those great whites. I don't want to go to the sun. Oh, there you are.
Integrity
compromised. And you're upside down. Oh my god, there's a comet that nearly got squished.
Landing gear retracted.
You're putting your landing gear down there, man.
Did you see me smash into the thing?
Yeah, I was right behind you. Okay. But there was a comet right behind you that nearly crashed into me, so I don't know what was going on there.
Frameshift drive charging.
I like if one of the police tries to pull you out of frameshift and you've got like 2% left on your horse, so he just destroys you when he takes you. He takes you out.
Oh. I've only got 80% on my horse. I don't know.
Engage.
I must have hit something. Maybe that guy actually crashed into me.
Hmm. Well, sorry.
We should buddy up for that 10% thing.
When I come out, I'll invite you. To Command an Edge, invite to Link.
Come on, let me click on it. No. What is happening, game? I'm stuck. Alright. Oh. There we go. Okay. Thank you.
Comes to Command and Edge open. We fucking closed down. We're only talking shite.
green beacon.
Oh, he appears to have gone up the window. Yeah. Definitely up the window.
He just really likes space jumping.
They came back in, so it's like, whoa. And he just, nope, see you later.
Like somebody was trying to interdict you or something. Wow, I'm miles away from it. 18 kilometers away. Far from it.
Tell you what, this landing pad 15 better not be by the fucking door. Just saying.
Oh no, I'm about to get wiped out by one of these rotating arms. Come on, don't crash. Don't crash.
Oh, have you come into this place? Yeah, yeah.
Oh no, 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 no. No.
No.
Come on.
No, no, no.
Oh, fuck's sake, 11%. It's hitting me. Yep, I'm destroyed.
Wow.
Oh my fucking god.
How much did you have?
Oh my god.
You're kidding me.
How did you get hit? What the hell?
I wanted the rotating arm, you know, the ring that's rough. I was flying through that, but misjudged how fast the arm part was spinning. So it collided with me. And obviously being a big ship, I can't. So that's 3.8 million to rebuy.
Wow.
Yeah. And that's without the,
yeah, they can't go
without
down
the
either.
Loss.
Stuff like this.
Docking successful. Engines disengaged.
Well, folks, it looks Commander Tribal's going to be giving you flippers in place of steady. So, appears to have had
I'm
a
in
bit
the,
of a...
I think I'm in the same park.
Yeah, is that a bit of
no,
an unfortunate happenstance?
I knew it as well so long before it happened. Nothing you can do. Marine equipment again. Fucking brilliant. What a waste of money. What a fucking waste of money.
Yay, my rank's up to 19. So all of that's gone
3%.
Oh, 19%. Up. 19. Yeah, 3%.
Yeah, but you have percentage. You have a percentage within each rank.
Engines engaged.
that's like your 19% of the way towards the next rank, you got to say.
No, it says merchant, trademark merchant, 19%.
Yeah, I'm saying you're 19% of the progress towards your next rank. That's what that tells you. Like, I'm 94% of the way to the next rank. It's not, what I'm saying is that it's not like you get to 20% and then you get a broker or whatever. I don't know. Confusion.
I thought it was... if I've got 20%, let's say I've got 20%, it means I've got another 80% to go before I rank up.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying, it's a progression.
Yeah, it's going to take fucking forever. That's my point.
Yeah. But I mean, I think you're only like 3 or 4 ranks away from maxing it out, so... Yeah. And you haven't even got anywhere near the best chips yet, so it's probably... tiered in such a way that you max it out by the time you get the biggest ship.
Yeah. I'm last locked.
What ridiculous impression.
Frameship,
so that's like set me back by at least 4 or 5 trips in order to recover that loss. How much money have I actually got now? I need to see whether I'm like close to the wire.
4, 3,
I don't think I have very 2, much money to
1,
begin with.
Engage.
$11 million left, so I can afford to crash another 3 times.
Is that how much money you got? $11 million.
That's. Yeah.
Cool, catching you up. Well, steadily. Steadily. Should have 9 after this.
Yeah, but. Yeah, that's 11 million, but I. Like, the Pythons. Hang on. Let's see what the Pythons are. That doesn't tell you what the Pythons actually valued at, it just tells you the insurance cost. But yeah. I think.
Yeah, I know you bought a lot more than me. You played this for like $1,000, so of course, yeah. But,
yeah.
Like, it's still nice that we're getting close in money, though. So,
yeah.
My risk is your risk, sort of thing.
Oh, we'll have to see if people want to do Secret Hitler on Sunday.
Yeah.
Put that on Facebook. Especially now where Dan's bought it and that. Dan copy.
Well, aren't you coming to Durham on Sunday?
Oh, yes, Sunday. Yeah. Yes, that's what I'm forgetting. About that, yeah.
I mean, I'll do it Saturday. But...
Yeah, I suppose. When you flew out, did you see my wreck? So I had like 280 tons worth of fucking marine equipment. So I would have thought that made.
It was quite the spectacle, yes. It was quite the spectacle.
Like made my rain.
Like my scanners were going fucking mental, all these flippers and snorkels I'm hammering off them.
Yeah.
Study was here. Things though, if you had shield, you'd be alright.
Hey, there's another guy here. Commander Veldrin Hedgehog.
Oh, that's rare.
That's a bad name. Yeah, he's doing the same run as going to Harvest Port as well.
Well, that's not allowed. We need to kill him.
With our freighters.
Yeah, this is our run. take a type 6 to the face.
Landing gear deployed. He's in the Python, so he'd probably win that battle.
I fucking hate it, everyone's got a Python, everyone's like, oh yeah, Python. No, just go with the Cobra, prove you got balls. Go with the Cobra and, you know, soup it up. Because it can take down a Python. Easily. If you are.
Oh yeah. Docking
successful. Don't need to have
I mean,
the
when
best
we were thing. Doing the conflict zones and that, we were taking Pythons down quite regularly, weren't we?
Mm. Didn't you have better shit than that, though? You had like a thingy, didn't you? Like a.
I had a vulture, but that's a damn sight not more cheaper than a python. A python's like 60 million base price, a vulture's only 7 million.
Wow.
We were taking down anacondas, which are like 90 million to buy. So yeah. Oh, he's got a tiger paint job on it.
Taking...
I'll be interested to see whether I still get a share of the monies, even though I wasn't here.
Marine equipment. The less lucrative. Of the drums. I'll probably get to 10 million then call it.
Right.
Sure.
Yeah. I'm going another two onion heads to buy. 10
million. Yeah, but it takes up.
No, space. But I don't have the previous ones because I wrecked. Yeah, I don't want to craft when I've got the slaves, because that's £4 million of credits. So yeah. Let me see. No, I don't get any because of share of your money. Shame.
Ship released. Engines engaged.
Zamina talk.
Landing gear retracted.
I'm kind of worried about where he is, whether he's in pirating mode or what. He's still landing. Yeah, I think I'm alright.
So how much is a Cobra? I can't remember.
300 or something.
300 grand.
Mm-hmm.
How much better is a Vulture than a Cobra?
Well, like I said, the best sort of fighting ship you can get, really, because you have large category weapons, two of them, and that's pretty much the same standard as what the Python has, and you're on a little nippy fighter.
No, well, I'll probably get
so
one
yeah, definitely.
I'll keep this
ship. Only one category bigger, and that's on an Anaconda, and that's its main fixed gun. That's why whenever you're fighting like an anaconda, do not be right in front of it because it'll shoot you with its main gun. I think that's a category 6, and vultures and pythons can have up to a category 6. Category 7, category 6 then. That's one of the things they're adding in a new patch, is new huge weapons,
All seems to be top end stuff, doesn't it? Not really for us. Weirdly, since you've played this game for like thousands of hours, still, you know, still scrimping, yeah, really, aren't you? You're not really going to get the Anaconda for another fucking couple of thousand hours. Ridiculous.
Well, I'm making nearly a million a run, so this is a really lucrative run, what we found. But, So, things are, it's getting exponential, it's getting much more quicker. And then all I need is, like, to get 90 million, get a type 9 heavy, and they can have, like, up to 500 tons per run. So if you get one of them kitted out, you must be raking in at least, sort of, 2 million per return journey. So, I wouldn't have thought there'd be too many runs after doing that to get
an Anaconda.
I just like making progress. It's quite nice.
Yeah, your next upgrade is an Asp Explorer. It has a 128 ton cargo capacity, so it's not that much better than what you've got now, but
that's
a lot more nippier. No, that's its max.
That's a max.
The next proper freighter is a Type 7, and you won't get that until you've got like 30 million or something. For that, that's 232, I think it is, max. And it's quite nice because it's a first ship you get that uses a large docking bay or whatever you call it. You know, the pads in the station. Different sizes, aren't they? So it's the first one you get that uses a large one.
Docking request granted.
I mean, it's good that we're both working at it and getting a bit of money, because when we do have multi-crew ships, hopefully we'll be able to combine our money and get a reasonably good ship between us.
Yeah. Looking forward to that. That's something that should have been in the game from the fucking start, to be honest.
To be honest, I don't think they would have put it in if it wasn't for Star Citizen doing a similar thing.
The only problem is the Star Citizen charges you real money for the chips, which is
landing gear deployed.
The height of gold.
Yeah. Like I said to you before, I don't think that'll last too long. When people start playing it properly, they won't be happy if they have to pay more money on top of it just to get a fictional top chip.
No. I just like one of these games to get it right, though. It's like, why do I need to spend 2,000 hours to get me Anaconda? Why can't I just fucking work really hard, play the game every day for a couple of hours, and then get me Anaconda after, like, a couple of months? You know, it seems fair enough to me.
Like, yeah.
Why do you need to grind so much? It's too much of a grind. And they're saying, oh, well, we were expecting you to do other things, not, you know, you're not playing the game in the way that we thought. Well, that's your fucking fault, isn't it? For not realising that people would want the best stuff. Because, of course, people want the best stuff. You're a fucking moron if you think, oh, well, you know, they're fine, and we want all the best stuff. Of course we will. Gamers, that's what they want. Yeah. Yeah, I honestly don't get what they mean when they say that. It's just, that's an excuse to me. You know, it's not,
well, I've seen
your
people
problem
with, like, billions, and I just can't imagine playing this game to earn billions of credits.
Most of them have been gifted that by Frontier, apparently. Scott Manley was saying.
Oh, really?
Yeah. For being streamers and for being backers and stuff, they get billions for it. Which is complete and utter horse shit.
Why be so harsh on what would be 99% of your player base, who are people they give you the money, the profit, because them sort of people are the gift of the game, don't they?
Yeah.
So exactly. You're not making any money out of them, but yet they get all the rewards, and everyone who pays and actually gives you your living gets all the shite. Stupid.
Well, this is what they've been like since the start. Even with Horizons, do like that. That's the model they wanted to go with. Was that? Oh yeah. If you back the game, yeah, you get Horizons. If you didn't back the game and you just paid for the game later on, out of your hard-earned cash, you can go and fuck yourself. You want the money twice. And if you're a new player, you get it for free. You know, that's just what they like. This is what they like. You know, the fucking horrible thing to say, but they are robbers. They looked at what Star Citizen are doing. They're going, ah, well, we'll do that. No, just be what you were. Like, just give us what you said you're going to give, because the reason why I bought this game was to have the things that you said were going to be in, that were going to be in Horizons and other expansions, and so far I've seen nothing. So, you know, I don't see what the word
I do get what you're saying, but I do think that people who were kickstarting it or backing it or whatever should get some. They should have more rewards than others, but they took on a lot more risk.
Yeah.
They didn't even know the game was going to be built or whatever.
Yeah, no, I understand.
But
that.
Too far the other way around.
They should get a discounted price or just get it for free. Yeah, and I don't mind having to pay for it. That's not what I'm saying. I'll pay for it. I'm just not paying full fucking AAA price for it when I've already bought your game. You know, and it's not even, you can't even land on planets with fucking water. That's pathetic.
Yeah.
That's absolutely pathetic. Can you land on a planet with lava? No. Can you land on a planet with any sort of atmosphere? No. Okay. That's bullshit then, because on your cover art you have a guy in a buggy next to a fucking city. So you're liars. Basically, that's false advertising. That's not in the game when you buy it. And it doesn't say on Steam that it's not in the game when you buy it.
Yeah. I mean, when you do land on the planets you do land on, you do get like little city complex things, but they're not that big.
No.
They look like, they've got spires and stuff like that, they look like sort of.
Mm.
I get what you're saying. I don't know whether they'll even add that in. I mean, stuff like water and lava and stuff might be too graphically intensive for this game, I don't know.
Maybe.
What do you make of No Man's Sky? Have you kept up with that?
It's too cartoony for me. I mean, I'll probably give it a go, depending on the reviews. I need a new game for the summer, really. So.
Yeah. Same here, I'll probably pick it up. It's pretty expensive, like, I'm wanting £50 for it, or something.
That's why I'm looking at reviews first. And for Warhammer 2, I'm leaving, I'm not touching that with a fucking very long stick.
Yeah.
I can't wait for the tears. I know we shouldn't say that, but I can't wait for everyone in BUD to start fucking whinging. Oh, shit, it never doesn't fucking work. And I'll be like, yeah, told you. Fucking told you.
Do you know anyone who's pre-ordered?
Yeah.
Well, that'll be the first one. Yeah. Just
I think Tom's pre-ordered it, Dan's pre-ordered it, Michael's pre-ordered it.
Wow.
So, I'm just going to be like, well, sorry guys, let it say.
Well, it'll certainly be an exception to the rule if it comes out all nice and optimised and no bugs. Certainly will be.
Well, I'm
not. See it first.
I'm not saying it should be no bugs, because that's impossible for a game like Total War, and it's unfair really to say it should have no bug, because even the amazing Total Wars have had bugs when it's come up, and even the amazing Total Wars have had some balancing issues when it's come up, but they've not been outright broken, and they've not been shit games. And the original Rome 2, when it came out, was broken and it was a shit game. It was a shit. With a lot of patches and some mods, it's a good game now and I enjoy it. But I still can't play it because there's a lot of me that's still very bitter. I'm like, no, do you know what? Fuck you. This is, you know what? Why do I need to fix this myself? And anyone who says it's a great game base is a fucking liar. Is a fucking liar. Who wants to justify paying £35 for it because they're butthurt. Because they got scammed by CA. I'll hold my hand up and say I got scammed. I got absolutely scammed by CA. But fool me once, shame on you. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, we were both in the same boat, weren't we?
Yeah.
When that all happened.
Fool me once.
And I mean...
Fair enough, but fool me twice. It's
if there were Steam refunds when that game came out, we would have both refunded it.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, I know I certainly would have.
Definitely. I remember the first battle we did, and it was like, Landing gear deployed. We were testing it out, and you went like the horse, like a horse faction, and I went the phalanx, and you just charged straight into it. And
yeah.
I was like, oh well, yeah, well, if you've done it right, I should win here. And you just went straight through them and killed them all. I was like, and the phalanx was lowered and braced and not moving. And you know, I was just like, this is fucking ridiculous. This. For someone who's like an ancient warfare guy, I was just fucking embarrassed for them. I said, you're just fucking idiots, honestly. Really are.
Well, you don't even have to be anybody with any sort of ancient historical knowledge. You can tell that somebody with a big stick is going to have severe... like, you know, it's going to decimate a horse driven army or whatever.
Mm.
And that was just a sign of things to come, really, with that battle. Ridiculous. I was going to mention something, but it's kind of on my mind.
I'm not huge on the, on Rome 2 and... Then they brought out Attila, and it was the same fucking game with a reskin. And people were like, oh yeah, give it a chance. Like, oh, fuck off with you. Who are you, Era Carthage, sucking the cocks, because they take you up to Berlin and give you in a hotel. And that's what really pissed me off as well, is these YouTubers who just kept sucking the cock of the game, going, oh, it's good, isn't it? It's good, isn't it? And it's like, no, it's not good, mate. You're only saying that because they flew you out to Berlin to a nice little swanky do. And had you played the game there for ages and gave you money for it, so don't give me shit saying that it's a good game when it's not. Prince of Macedon and Heir of Carthage are fucking sellouts, both of them. What is it, Kappa for...
I think it...
For
Nassus or whatever.
For Nassus, yeah.
Yeah, what you were saying about you don't expect games to be released without bugs. I can't remember what Corruptional podcast or something like that I watched, but in the days of like the 90s where you had consoles, a game released, there was no updates or anything like that, and yet they all turned out fine. So it's basically just people pushing a luck and being really lax about the game. I mean, just take an extra month or whatever, do it properly, release it. If you could do it in the 90s, you can do it now. Don't rely on the fact that you can send out updates.
I think the only thing that I'd say to that is that stuff has got a lot more complicated and bigger. So the bigger thing is the more proponency there is for bugs and, you know, things to go wrong in a program. You know, the more you fill it full of code, the more likely things are to go wrong. And but at the same time, on the other counter to that argument, you could say, well, people in the 90s, that was full of code to them. That was a lot of code. Do you know what I mean? Because it was still new. And they weren't getting everything fucking wrong. So, you know, those are the two ways I think about it. But,
make a point.
Like, I don't know. I just think a lot of these games now with the, was it Day 1 DLC and I saw this graph the other day, and it says, you know, gaming back in the day, it was like a Mona Lisa. And it's like, yeah, you'd just buy the Mona Lisa, and then the expansion pack would come out, and it would be like a smaller Mona Lisa or another painting. So yeah, this expansion pack. Uh-huh. And it says gaming today, and it's like a quarter of the Mona Lisa, and then the other four parts are in DLC, and then the expansion pack's actually a sequel with same thing happening to it. It's just like, yeah, exactly what's happening. Frameshift drive. Things are being chopped up left, right, and center. Like this game. Like this game.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you just, you know, admit that this is still in beta? Because it is. Because, like, around 70% of the stuff you said was going to be in the game, which is basically the main role-playing stuff, isn't in the game yet. I respect the achievement of having so many star systems and, you know, and having really nice ship-to-ship combat and things like that. That's nice. But I also think, at the same time, you know, at the very least, this game should have been released with Horizons part of the game in its entirety. Do you know what I mean? All of it is in the game when on release. That would then I'd be okay. Yeah. This is a solid foundation to build on now. This is really good, and I would actually give them a pass for a year. I'd be like, yeah, you know, don't bring anything else out for a year. Just work on new stuff, and you know, update it so bugs are taken out and stuff. But you know, mainly just update, work on the next update. But what they've done is they've given you the bare bones of a game that's fucking punishing in how much trawling around and grinding you have to do, and then they act surprised when you go and grind, because, you know, they say, oh, well, the really interesting stuff's out there. Well, to be fair, the galaxy's a big fucking place, mate, and we're not superhuman, we're not psychic, so, you know, it's alright trying to be space tough and fucking manly and be like, oh, yeah, you know, you gotta go find it yourself, noob. It's like, well,
yeah.
No, this is a game, mate, and you've never been in a fucking spaceship, alright? This is a game, and you need to tell me where certain things are. You need to just say, okay, this is here, this is there, and just as a general, you know, and say, hey, do you wanna go and see Earth? Well, this is what you gotta do. Do you wanna go and do this? This is what you gotta do. You know, bring out a comprehensive guide for each and everything that's in the game. It's just not hard. Mm. And, you know, it's such a huge game. And
apparently, that's what the Galnet, or the Galaxy News stuff, is supposed to be for. That, like, tells you of any conflicts and then you go there. But have you seen how many articles there is?
Yeah.
I'm not going to. I came in to fly shit, not to read.
Not to read the fucking paper.
Worth of,
yeah.
In order to know where to go for the best loot or whatever.
I think this is why me and John had a disagreement, because he was like, oh, well, I want to fly the ship, I don't want to have a bar. I was like, well, why'd you sit there reading the fucking Galnet for half an hour? You want to fly the ship, you don't want to be reading fucking Galnet for half an hour.
Yeah, he seemed like he was a bit upset about us using Thrugs or whatever, wasn't he?
Yeah.
But I mean,
it's like, you know, why are you using Thrugs? You know, I've got fucking, I don't have. How else are you supposed to know? How else are you supposed to know where things are? Because, you know. Oh, well, just use Galnet. Well, Galnet's shite. You know, Galnet is absolutely awful.
Yeah.
I mean,
we've got better things to do than to do a load of pointless trading that could end up with losses. Because if you did it without Thrones, you'd be thinking, oh, well, I'll take this. Be take it here, see if I get a profit, right? But you could do that loads of times and end up with tons of loss, because you don't know where you're taking the stuff to, like what places you should be taking to.
Yeah.
And I honestly think something like the likes of Thrones would be a thing that would be in this universe.
Definitely.
Like, it makes sense.
Like the stock market or something.
The traders would have some sort of database to know where the best trades are.
Well, this is what I mean. They try to be realistic, but in a galaxy this size, people need to eat. People need to, you know, people are going to be on world and they're going, oh shit, we need to terraform this, or we need to do this, that, and the other. So there would be a system where it wouldn't be like Galnet, where it's fucking vague and it's like, oh, well, is it this here or is it there? I don't know. Let's see. It would actually be something like Thrud's, where it's like A, B, C, D. A needs this, C needs this, D needs this. And that would be how easy it is, because it would be deadly otherwise. You'd all die, you'd all starve, if people didn't know what to bring where. If people had to troll through fucking Galnet and real knife, everyone would be dead. This is the most unrealistic game ever made. Because everyone's dead already, because Galnet is not enough. It just is not enough. You know, I respect what they're trying to do, and I respect that. It's different to Eve, and it's different to Star Citizen, and that's fine. But you know, where's people like, oh yeah, you know, they really like role players. Well, they mustn't, because there's no way to do it in this game. Like in Eve, there's tons. And I know you shouldn't really compare this to Eve, because it was set up as alternative to Eve. But you know, if you say you like the role players and they're the real, they've said they are the true players of Elite Dangerous, that they're role players, then that's fine. But I can't really role play when I'm just a man in black with blue glowy fingers and man boobs. That's literally all I am. That is the height and length of my character. I am just a random person sitting. I am pilot A. I am pilot, you know, 4,153. That's who I am. Great. Well, you know, I feel so special. They need to learn from Eve, and I'm sick of them treating Eve like it's a bad word. Like it's, oh, no. Well, I'm sorry, but Eve does a lot of things right and a lot of things well, because they've had, you know, 11 fucking years making the game, if more than that, you know. So you need to listen and watch and learn, because the last time you made a game was in the fucking 80s, and it shows. This is a game for anoraks. Do you know what I mean? And that's fine.
Uh-huh.
That's completely fine, but you can't then complain that not many people play the game and they're not getting the game, they're not playing it the way that you want them to play it, because they're anoraks, of course they're going to grind, because that's your target audience. So I just think there needs to be a lot of, I think they need to look at Eve and stop treating it like it's the casual game. No, it's not. It's a better game than this, I'll tell you that. I'll tell you that for nothing.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's a much better game than this. I mean, when all the stuff is added to Elite Dangerous that you say is going to be added, then I think this will blow Eve right out the fucking water. Because it's not even a subscription-based game. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, certainly will. Come December, when they're all out, yeah.
But
the problem is by then, Star Citizen's will be out.
Yeah.
And I have a feeling that Star Citizen is going to trump this. No ends. I know the money thing, which, that's really not going to last. It really can't. I don't know.
You can't. It's not a sustainable model.
Well, it's not just that. Is that no? You wouldn't have anything to work. You wouldn't have anything to work for. All the whole point of doing this is you want a better spaceship. You want better. You want to upgrade things. You want to improve. Like your gameplay experience, and you can't. What's the point in playing the game if you can't? If that's all pointless, the actual playing part is pointless. It's only how big your wallet is how good of the experience you have. That it's just not going to work. People won't. You need to get like dangle the carrot on the stick or whatever, don't you? You have to have something to go for.
I mean, that's the frustrating thing, because. Like, sometimes you've got to look at another game and say, okay, they did that right, so let's do that. You know. I don't mean like BioWare, where they looked at Skyrim and said, oh, look, Skyrim did quite well, let's make an open world game. It's like, well, you fucked that up, didn't you? Because you didn't know what an open world game's supposed to have in it, quite clearly, because there's nothing here. You know, it's very pretty, but there's nothing in it. Like, you have. I mean, CD Projekt Red did it right. They say, oh, we want to do Skyrim. Hey, let's go to Bethesda and lease all of their fucking employees. Yeah, let's do that. So then they just went to Bethesda and say, can we have your employees, please, for 6 months? We'll pay you X amount of money. So yeah, we'll give you 20 of our programmers for that. Okay, fine. And they just made The Witcher 3, and it was fucking fantastic. And it was an open world game. You know, it just... People, I don't get why Star Citizen, Eve, and... Elite Dangerous don't just look at each other and go, well, they do that right, ooh, yeah, you know, and they take in ideas from each other's games. Because, I swear, if I could walk around this ship as a commander that I've customized, as I can see his face, I can even hear his voice, you know what I mean, I can see his, you know, everything about it. and I can walk around the ship, see the different rooms in the ship, and when it's filled up with cargo, I can see the big cargo things. You don't need to make them look any different. They'll just be crates. Do you know what I mean? That's all. They're just crates. And you can program, like, because you've only got so many resources in the game that you can buy, so have, like, a different crate for each one. So that'd be really fucking cool. And then, like the rares would look really funny, because they'd be, like, the, like, fish tanks with fish in them and things. Why don't... Uh-huh. You know, instead of focusing on just saying, oh, well, we need to make it, you know, the commander creator has to be like that. I want to walk around my ship. I want to go to one of these places. You know, it's all right, space being lonely, but let me go to Wellman Gateway, like I'm going to now, and have like a bar or like a meeting place where I can get off my ship, I can go walk around, and I can see people walking around, because there's millions of people on there, so I can see about 20 to 30 people walking around, doing NPCs doing their own thing. I can see all the players there gambling or drinking or enjoying some downtime, because, you know, that's role playing, and I'd love that. I'd mark out for this game so much if they did some of that. And these people go on.
Yeah, it's the exact point you're making, is that they sell themselves as a simulation, but so far I'm simulating a vegetative fucking man in a cockpit all the time.
Yeah,
you know, this isn't a real simulation of what a space career or whatever. A human in space in the whenever 3,000 years ahead in the future would be like. You're not going to be permanently strapped into your cockpit and do fuck all.
Well, apparently there are no women in space either, because I've yet to see a female commander. So apparently there are absolutely no women in space, because, you know.
You can change to female. It's just in the options menu, so that's probably, it's an option, you can put female or male.
That must be new. I never knew you could do that.
So that's probably why there's no females, is that people forget to change it.
But I'm just looking at it and thinking, you know, like, I know that would be a ball egg to put in, but not really. It just need to be, you could even do it like Rebel Galaxy, where it just, you don't actually move around, it's just like a camera looking at a bar. And you can choose to talk to people, and you can, it's like a chat room or something. That'd be fine. You know, and just have animations in the background of people drinking and walking around and doing stuff, that's fine. That'd be great. And then the only place you can actually walk around is on your ship. That's great. I'd love to do that. You can invite other people onto your ship and stuff. Great. You know, really simple stuff like that. But just the little touches that will make the role playing in this so much better. And if they actually did stuff like that, I would absolutely go fucking mental. I'd be like, this is the best thing ever. Like, literally the best thing since sliced bread. I'd be going off my head. But at the moment, you know, it's a beautiful game, and it's a nice, you know, it's a nice thing to do, just to go flying around and see the galaxy and, you know, do all sorts of nice little things. But it's not.
Yeah.
It doesn't have. It doesn't have any depth. It's like, okay, I'm going to go and get. You know, all of these Imperial slaves. All right. Well, all that is a number to me. That's it. It doesn't. I know it's got a description, but it's not just a number. Why can't I go in the back and see, back of my ship, and see, like, you know, all of these slaves just standing in cages and stuff and just milling around doing nothing. That'll be fun, you know. I mean, why can't? And how do 110 tons of slaves fit on a ship this size?
Yeah, no, that's the thing, amazing thing. Yeah.
Am I a giant? Like, am I literally fucking huge? That's the only way. That's what I mean. It's just a number. And I get nothing from that. I'm just like, well, whatever. You know, if you don't care, I don't care. So, and you obviously don't. So, you know, sounds butthurt, because...
I mean, come December, you're going to get the game that you just described, right? Where you can walk around and stuff like that, according to what they're saying. But by the way, that is only probably for Horizon, so... Yeah, good luck flying around in your empty fucking void.
Yeah.
if you don't pay for Horizons.
Yeah, well, I will get it eventually, but I'm not paying their price for it. I'll get it some other means. Because it's just ridiculous the amount that they're asking for. Still is, even though it's
going down. What you were saying about trying to take a few notes from Eve, I think they are trying to do that, even in 2.1, because I don't know whether you watched that video that I sent you, but they're creating this competition so that a player-run faction will be one of the major powers within, you know, like how there's Federation and there's Empire currently. They're going to make it so that, like, a player made faction will be able to compete with that. Oh, I think that's them trying to create a sort of Goon Swarm type thing, like Sex Article.
The thing is, is that.
See how that goes.
In Eve, Goon Swarm and Band of Brothers came about organically because that's just how the game was set up and they just let the players get on with it and do it and it happened. Right?
Yeah, I'm the biggest, I'm the boss, that's just the way it seems
In Eve, I mean, in Elite Dangerous, it seems like they have trying to artificially get that. Do you know what I mean? They're trying to like say, oh, you're doing this now. It's like, okay, why don't you just put that in the game? Why don't you look at Eve, is what I'm saying. Why don't you look at what they do right and just do that? You know, take the good, leave the bad. I love the fact that the galaxy is so big that you very rarely run into trolls. That's great.
Landing gear retracted.
Take the good from Eve and just leave the bad where it leave. You know, because obviously, Elite Dangerous is a different game. It's nice. It's cool. It's basically a game for the Care Bears from Eve to come over and, you know, do their mining and their whatever. Because the shit you get for being a pirate on this game, honestly. Like, you get just chewed out constantly.
You see, I wouldn't mind it. It's just that the differential in what they will get for your 1,000 credit bounty that you, because you forgot to pay a fine in this fucking system 500 light years away. They get their 1,000 credit thing. And you end up losing £500 worth of credits worth of.
Yeah.
Of shipping cargo. That's the thing that gets me. In Eve, there's a reason why they're doing that. You know, they want your cargo, they get you of an enemy faction or something. There's some politics behind it. You probably, like we did when we tried to kill that NoSec bro. They had no reason to kill us, but I think it was just because we were in their territory or whatever that we ended up getting started, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, like what you're saying, I think you make a good point, is that them doing this competition or whatever to make the first major player-run faction isn't going to work.
No.
Because they don't have the tools within the game, like Eve has.
To maintain it, yeah, there's no
you
social...
You can make your own contracts.
Yeah, there's no social interaction or whatever. I mean, it's...
So it's just not going to work, isn't it?
The reason why it worked in Eve is because they garnered it. They nurtured it. They said, okay, we want a community. We want you to... We're going to give you all the social tools. It's going to be really easy to type into chat to other players. It's going to be really easy to voice chat to them. It's going to be really easy to go and find people on the net and see where they are or put bounties on them or simply trade. You can give them some money if you want. Just straight into their account. Fine. Not a problem. Whereas this fucking thing... It's just like, no, you can't do that, no, you can't do that, no, you can't do that. And these are all things, it's not like people saying, oh, well, it's coming. Well, it should be there, because it's elementary. It's like, you know, there should be stars in space. Do you know what I mean? That's how elementary it is, having social things in this game. It should be just elementary, just, you know, you do that, it's fine. And with it not being there, it's like, well... You can't just artificially say, boom, there it is. You know, you should be nurturing it, you should be garnering it yourself, rather than just saying, oh, well, that faction X is now going to be a major player. Look what we did, guys, look how social we are. No, you're not social. You're not social, you're not being social. Like, why the fuck would I give a fuck about that faction? I don't know who these people are. Never met them before in my life. I don't know what they're about. I don't know why they're... But on Eve, I can just go on a simple little tab. I can go onto their advertisement page and I'll know exactly who they are and what they stand for and what they're trying to do. And if I want any part of it or not. You know, just... They seem to want to import that without having the infrastructure, which is what I'm saying. They should be looking at other games and saying, well, they do that well. You know, look, Eve really do set the standard in this kind of game for social interaction. So let's take the good from Eve. Because there's no harm in that. Let's acknowledge that they've done something correct and say, okay, we'll take that and we'll just make our own game with it.
What's the house about, Carol? Yeah, totally.
I had a few things I was going to say, but...
Yeah, I mean, again, there will be people who play Eve who would have loved to jump in this and have this sort of flight simulator-esque experience of a space game. If they had the tools, sort of doing Swarm and stuff, Band Brothers or whatever they were called, they would have migrated here naturally if the tools were there to do it. But so no amount of like you trying to create a competition, yes, somebody will win that competition, but like you said, it would just be this other thing like Federation and Imperials are on here, or Empire are.
It's just empty, really, and a bit sterile. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? It's like, well, you know.
Even the stuff that they have implemented, like the voice chat, you know, that's all nice and well for fucking half an hour having the crackle and the pop like you're on a proper radio, but just got fucking annoying, you know.
Yeah, that's one thing that really grinds my gears. You couldn't just give us fucking voice chat, could you? No, you had to be a fucking geek about it, didn't you? You had to put it in a fucking annoying crackle. Like, we're actually in a spaceship. Look, we're actually in a spaceship. Fuck off. You're a game, right? And I say it again, you've never been in a spaceship, David Braben. You've never been in a fucking spaceship.
Landing gear deployed.
How the fuck do you know that, you know, this is 3,000 years later? We might have fucking HD screens with them sitting there talking to us, wanking off. To us sitting here in our fucking black latex, that's all we ever wear. You know, how do you know? You know. Fucking stupid. You know, it's just at least, if you're gonna do that, let us turn it off. Let us just turn off the filter and say, you know what, this sound isn't doing it for me, man. I wanna, like, actually hear what my friend is saying rather than hearing your fucking obnoxious impression of the lunar landings in 1969. You know, I wanna.
Yeah.
You know.
And I've yet to find somebody who actually appreciates that, because even Dan got his way once, didn't he?
Yeah.
And said, "Oh, should we use it?" So we went on it with him within like half an hour, whatever, 15 minutes. Oh yeah, guys, I know what you mean.
Back to Steam.
Just stupid. Yeah. And the thing is, that's such an old idea that radios have these sort of interference. This is the fucking 30, like the third millennium or whatever.
Yeah.
We don't have that problem now, it's all digital.
Yeah. I mean, there's absolutely no reason why there should be stuff like that in the game. It's just that, well, hang on, you know, if I can travel the speed of light and then go into super cruise, which is basically the speed of light, nearly, then, you know, I should be able to talk to my friend in the same system without it, you know, sounding like I'm in a fucking trench in World War One. You know, should be able to. I mean, I would implement it.
Engines engaged.
I'm fucking hell, it's busy in this port. Jesus. Asp and a vulture, I think.
Are they players?
No, it's a Type 7 transporter. No, none of them are players.
At least dangerous rants. Wildly players.
be fair, I like the game. You know, I've I mean, it annoys me sometimes because I'm thinking, you know, there are so many. Nearly every time I've died or something shitty's happened to me, it's been because of a fault. I've not like been killed in combat or anything like that. No, it's been. I've not even killed myself by crashing. It's been just, you know, something fucking stupid where it doesn't tell you something. Like, people saying, well, you shouldn't need to be told. Well, hang on a second. You remember that time when my fuel went down from half to fucking zero for, like, no apparent reason?
Landing gear,
you know,
retracted.
And there was no warning, no nothing. I was like, well, that's silly. Why does that happen? You should tell me. I don't know.
Yeah.
I do like it. I just don't like the grind, and I think it's a sea that's about a foot deep.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
You know. People said Skyrim had that problem. Well, it did, but it had enough there. It had about 90 hours worth of content there before you started to notice. Do you know what I mean?
Frameshift drive charging.
Yeah.
Whereas this, it's people say, yeah, you got like hundreds of hours of content. Yeah, but it's the same fucking content over and over and over and over. Do you know? So.
Yeah, the thing with Skyrim is it had the history and the lore behind it. You did a quest, you felt like you were uncovering something about this new world.
Yeah.
Whereas this, you do a quest, and you just like, oh, get me Imperial slaves and bring them back. You're not learning anything about how we became spacefaring, anything about any other aliens that might be around, anything like that. You just...
And don't tell me to go and buy some books. I'm sick of fucking people saying that who would defend this game. Don't tell me to go and start buying books, giving them more money, just so they can explain what the fuck's going on when they should be explaining it in the game. The same people who were apologising for the Star Wars prequels, oh, it's in the books, I don't care if it's in the books. It should be in the fucking movie, you know.
Yeah, even if they did that, like what Eve does, where you have the little 5-minute video before you pick your faction.
Yeah, it's fine.
With each race, telling you a bit about them and where they came from and what their beliefs are and whether they're... any animosity to other races and stuff like that. I mean, that was all good. That's all I needed to do for this.
Mm.
15 minutes or whatever. Not even that. Just a little cinematic, just so that it gives you some context to why you're flying about. But you load up the game and instantly you're in a sidewinder. Off you go.
Mm.
Start grinding missions.
Can you do first person in Eve? I don't think you can you? Or can you?
First person?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can.
Oh, okay.
Only in the port, you can just look around like the captain's quarters and stuff like that.
Mm.
So even they haven't really perfected it that well. I think you can invite people to your quarters or whatever. Just,
no, I mean like when you're actually sitting in your cockpit. I can't even remember what it was like.
Oh, no, I don't think you can.
It's third person, isn't it? Yeah.
I think he's heading that way because the VR thing that they brought out is all first person, so I imagine that they'll transfer that over to the proper game at some point.
Yeah, it's not going to be too long till they get onto it.
I'll probably head back on Eve if they do that, because that'd feel badass.
I could see somebody coming up behind me and I got this bully food full of slaves, so I was like, nope, see ya. Just dropped out just in time.
Docking request granted.
Yeah.
So how come I'm trading slaves in Federation space? Isn't that illegal?
I think it's because they're Imperial slaves, not just regular slaves. So the Federation's like,
so
well, they're not. Yeah, we're adding workforce to the Federation, aren't we? Basically, Well, I don't know whether we're freeing them or whether it's just like a military thing, like giving, you know, like a better economy to the Federation because they've got more manpower.
Yeah. In my head, my dad is
like,
born on Morana and like lives in Minerva. That was like very nice.
Yeah.
To a Federation guy. He's not a
big guy. Landing gear deployed.
Yeah. So you're going to do the Federation military stuff?
Yeah, right? Yeah, definitely. I don't care about having the nicest ships, the best ships. I just want to play the game my own way. Because, after all of the blocks it puts in my way, I'm just going to choose my own fate and do what I want to do. I must say, like, it sounds like we fucking hate the game. We don't. We just think it
we wouldn't be playing it if we hated it.
No. It's a good game, it's just... No. I need one more run back and forth and then I'm done.
Yeah, same here. I need to get off the bed.
What are you up for tomorrow?
Yeah. I got an interview.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, alright.
What's it for?
Wiki management, it's a consultancy firm for different businesses and stuff like that. They basically go in and like help out and get ones that are like at making losses, try and make them more profitable. So should be interesting stuff, isn't it?
Yeah. For Kappa, what's it called? Four Nasses.
I just look on the map. Like, the map opens up in the same point of view every time and you shoot right next to it.
For some reason it wasn't, like, coming up. It was just... I think it needs to scroll in or out, it doesn't matter. But, yeah, it should be good, though. So you can get it.
Have you noticed that the, you carve it all when you sell it. When you sell the Imperial Slayers, it seems to be going down and fucking good. What the fuck is that just name?
My mind was about the same.
You see, I was making close to 1 million. Now I'm only making 900. So I don't know whether we are fucking up the economy or something by transporting too much.
Well, we're not really. Fucking up the economy, we're helping the economy because it should be, you know.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that I think we're diluting it because, like, the cost, like, the price per ton of slaves is going down, so I don't know. Maybe I'm just reading it wrong, maybe I am. So,
I don't think it'll take more than what we've done to change the whole galactic. Well, the.
Oh, no, system. Just for that space part.
Yeah, that's what I mean, on. Yeah. I think it would take more than those, just those doing. Drive charging. It should do anyway, that'd be ridiculous. It's like, oh yeah, 10 jumps, you're done now. Yeah, okay. Then again, to get to the point where it's not profitable, it's gonna have to get down to like 250 grand per trip. So, it should be good for another like 30 trips. And then...
Yeah. And I think it'll replenish when we've logged off and stuff anyway.
Yeah. Gave me granddad there because they're flavours to read. Fucking hell. Wrecked his head. What the fuck is this?
You gave him what? Sorry?
Consider flavours to read.
Ah, oh, right.
Fucking wrecked his head completely.
Did he like sci-fi stuff?
Yeah. I was like, what the fuck is this? Why's he got three legs? I was like, yeah, no, that threw me off as well. I was like, what? I stopped reading it the first time I was reading it because of that. I was like, what the fuck, man? Come on. Really?
Yeah.
Then I was like, well, I
quite like it.
Yeah. Then I was like, oh,
it's wacky.
Yeah. I mean, I do like Mass Effect, and that's got like fucking Hanar in it, who are just jellyfish with legs. You know, just,
yeah. Self-righteous.
Yeah.
Pricks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I scammed one in Mass Effect 1 because we were on Noveria, and he was like, can you, now this one would appreciate you going and taking a shipment back to the Normandy. I was like, okay. This one will pay you 500 credits if you do. I was like, okay, fine, yeah, I'll do that. It's like, this one thanks you. And then I took his credit, went and just sold it in another shop next door.
Oh, yeah, I think I did the same thing.
He was just like, where are my goods? Fucking sold them, didn't I?
Yeah. Because you can report them as well, can't you? To the,
I didn't do that, I'm not a snitch, but I did sell them.
No, I think I did, though.
Oh.
That shows you mean.
That's why I hate goody
two-shoes. You can rely on Steady to do the evil stuff.
Yeah. That's the good, that's a Paragon one. Because it's like weapons and stuff, so it's like your renegade to put them on your ship and do what he says.
Alright.
There's even more renegades to like sell them to someone else who's obviously a dodgy character. We gave me more money.
I think I did sell them, but I still snitched on them. I don't know. That's neutral or whatever.
Yeah, there was a ship there. Came straight around.
Guy called
Javik.
That's a weapon. Javik. I was gonna say Jared, and I'm thinking that's not. The bit where meets him is quite funny. I recall. I can't really remember it too.
What, well, the Ara, yeah.
The Ara. He has an interaction with the Hanar guy.
Oh, Hanar. They're on a movie set. Yeah, I remember that. Yeah. Do you know two of those, the Hanar and like Blasto and Shepard are voiced by Mark Meer, voiced by the same person. He's doing his like just doing a scene with himself.
Alright. I suppose it wouldn't have, would they have done that? I don't know.
Yeah, they did, apparently.
Whether
they
would have had to do it all in one go, or whether they'd like put him in one character, do all of that character's lines, then
the fuck, man?
Like have a rest over him. Change it. What's up?
Like the letterbox trapped me in between two of its like spire things.
Oh, I bet that's fucking bullshit, isn't it? You can't even see what you've got on.
No.
So you just mash your buttons trying to get away.
Fucking stupid. And I've got slaves, fucking bastards. Nearly got me there.
Scan detected.
What, you've not exploded, have you?
No. Oh, fucking hell.
Oh, I just see you have that going down.
That just smacked my head on the thing. Oh, and look, it's right by the fucking door. Of course it is. When I'm down to this health. Yeah. Oh, fucking course. Thanks, game. Where's number 5? There it is. Yeah, nearly get smacked into by an asp. Yeah, of course I do. Yeah. My ship fucked or something. It's not flying correctly.
I might have some problem, I don't know. I didn't think they added stuff like that. I mean, if you want to look, you can look on the right hand panel and look at your different modules and see if something's being knocked out.
Well, we got away with that.
I don't know why I keep getting scammed. You've just seen me 5 minutes ago.
Yes, but we never know what has anything.
Everything looks fine, Commander. Have a good day. Well, you've just seen me fucking 5 minutes ago, man.
Fuck off.
Right. Yeah, that's a thing with No Man's Sky. It seems like it has all of the workings of a great game, like exactly what we want. But yeah, there's just no multiplayer. Yeah, and that's like, why can't we just have a game that encompasses everything? Why does somebody have to shoot themselves in the foot every time? I mean, you should watch some of the gameplay stuff.
I will do.
Because
I really like Rebel Galaxy, but the only problem with that is I can't go up or down, which just broke all of the immersion for me. I was like, why can't I... Like, this is space. This isn't... This is fucking ridiculous. Why can't I go up or down?
Yeah, no. And that's the same with the battle. I think it's the same. It's all in five, you can't go up and down, so... You may get pissed with that.
Well, are you actually piloting the ship in that, or I thought it was an RTS?
It is an RTS, but there's no up and down movement. You know, like...
If it's an RTS, I don't mind. But when I'm actually controlling the ship myself, like flying it, I'm like, why can't I go up or down? It's ridiculous.
Right. The amount of money we're getting is definitely going down because I've just lost like $6,000 returning slaves to Japan. Which isn't much really when you nearly make a million bucks.
No. Oh, we'll just bleed it dry then, and then move on to the next one. Drive charging. Yeah, was that
well, like I said, I think it'll replenish.
Yeah.
Log off for 24 hours, come back, and it'll be back up there. I mean, look, after all, I'm not in it. Did I actually buy, Yeah, I did buy 95% away. I'm not getting much there.
Some gravity of the sun there, slow me right down. Bastard. Oh, and someone's gaining on me. What a surprise. Last run of the night, don't you kill me on the last run of the night, you bastard. Don't you fucking dare. Well, good luck with your, I'm logging off in a minute once I've done this, so good luck with your interview tomorrow, man, and let me know how it goes and stuff.
Yeah, I will. Probably be gaming tomorrow night, I don't think I've got much on.
I feel sorry for Chris, the lad who lives in my house, because, like, Luke's moved out. And he's taken all of his stuff with him, like his PS3 and 4 and Xbox, so he's like, he's there and he's like, okay, yeah, but no one's in Durham. And he's like, what the fuck do I do? Got nothing to do.
Wow.
I'm like, fucking hell. So, yeah, when I go back on Sunday, that's why we're going out.
So yeah. Alright, cool.
I mean, my PC's not there anyway, so I'm not going to be having anything else to do, am I? So, may as well.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I'll have my laptop and stuff, but... I think we're doing the essay on it.
Good stuff.
I've been reading this book called Darth Bane. This is about
Really?
Well, Darth Bane. And he it's really good, actually, so far. It's better than the Revan one anyway, because the Revan one was very, you know, like they worship Revan, don't they? BioWare, so it's very, oh, Revan's so powerful. Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Whereas Bane's like completely new, so it's pretty cool.
Who's the author?
Drew Karpyshyn. He's basically, he's the guy who wrote the first two Mass Effects. So,
Alright. So, I see where you may have come across it from.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, I knew Darth Bane before, because he's on all those versus videos quite a lot. And he keeps winning, so I was like, oh, I wonder who this guy is. Seems quite powerful. So it's...
Alright.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, I've got the aftermath that I want to get through sometime, and also Darth Plagueis.
Darth Plagueis, yeah.
Star Wars, yeah.
It was a very good time. Full integrity compromised, are you fucking joking? Nothing wrong with it. That was the most perfect landing.
I very rarely properly land. I mean, have you noticed that you, when you like hover near the ground or whatever, you sometimes just takes over?
Oh yeah.
Or do you not get that thing? Yeah.
Yeah, I do, yeah. I've had a good night, so I'm gonna buy myself a beer whilst I'm here. Some beers.
A ton of beers.
I will have a ton of beers, please.
Fucking hell.
Let's have a... Oh, they don't sell it here. Bastards.
Yeah, I think I'll probably... Oh, shit. I'm not gonna hit that again, am I? For fuck's sake. Steady, what are you doing? Trying to... Nearly... Like, managed to recoup my losses of whatever I spent. But nearly fucking collided again. I would have probably just uninstalled that. That fucking guy on Rocket League. Fucking twat.
Which one?
The one that was saying. I missed one save.
Oh, yeah.
I was in. And it was steady
uninstall. Fuck off.
Fucking 1-0 down. Yeah. Come on, man. It's a...
Brilliant.
It's not like I'm missing things left, right, and centre.
No.
And of course, I got my best friend there. Yeah.
Steady
uninstall. Yeah.
Yeah. Fucking hell. It's fucking funny that fucking hell. So you don't really spend a lot on fuel, do you? 38 grand spent since I started the game.
Wow.
Bounties claim 9, profit from bounties 65 grand. Profit from combat bonds. Oh, 1,800,000. Combat bonds.
Yeah, that was when we were doing all of them conflict zones with John and Dan. Did quite a bit of that, didn't we?
Yeah. Apparently, I've only got. Oh, somebody's put a bounty on me. Oh, very nice. Am I in there? No.
Does it actually tell you how much the bounty is? Oh.
Yeah. 720, apparently.
Like, just 720 credits?
Yeah.
Wow. And you're gonna... You're gonna end... One of these days, somebody's gonna end up fucking destroying you for that. And you've lost. Makes no sense, man.
I'm gonna go back and get rid of it or something.